called the executive producers over to my house, and I told them that I wanted to come out. It became bigger than any of us ever anticipated.
I get a telephone call.
And my agent sends me this script.
And the character breakdown for the character of Taylor Mason said non-binary.
Hello, I'm Taylor. My pronouns are they, theirs, and them.
It's hard to talk about without stressing how invisible gay people were.
The earliest representations were always people to be mocked.
People couldn't be just who they were.
The truth is there was no LGBT presence on TV that I can remember.
In 1971, we wanted to show people as they really are.
In all that time, did I ever mention a woman?
It's the first time ever on an American sitcom that a character came out and said he was gay.
That was, to me, the breakthrough.
First of all, congratulations on this series. It's incredible. I want to hear, I know you two have worked together before, but I want to hear how you all came together for this, where the idea came from, and what made you want to do this series at this point in time.
We've been trying to make this for I've been part of it for 7 years, but even before that, my friend David Bender has been doing this for over a decade. He wanted to write a book, and then he was going to make a movie, and then we realized it was a lot of material, so we wanted to make a series. We tried to do it independently, we raised money, there was a lot of interviews that were done, and then we came to the terms with the fact that we weren't going to be able to do this alone, and that's when we went to Apple, and Apple brought on these amazing documentary filmmakers who have taken this raw material and actually created something really beautiful.
We were fighting for our lives.
I will probably die before I turn 30 years of age.
That's how much homophobia there is in the community.
This was the coming out moment for the movement on national television. This was the time they first saw us.
When you look back at television history, because the series is 5 episodes, mm-hmm. you get to chart, you know, the total invisibility and demonization of LGBTQ people at the beginning of television. And I think what was amazing about getting 5 episodes and Apple TV Plus giving us the real estate to tell the story, not just in a feature-length film, but to do it in a full-length series, allowed us to explore all of the nuances of television through the decades and see how far we've come, but also see how far we still have to go.
Yeah, absolutely. I love how you broke it down also. I love how you broke down the episodes. How did you decide you were gonna categorize it, only having 5 episodes?
So much of documentary directing happens in the edit room. Documentary editors never get enough credit. And so we had 3 amazing editors working on this project who had a team of dozens watching tens of thousands of hours of television footage. So it was a constant back and forth. I was going out, interviewing these people, bringing back their stories. Then we were weaving in the archival footage. And so it really didn't start to take shape until we started editing and the themes became clear. Because we interviewed almost 100 people, and when you would hear certain shows or characters bubbling up over and over, that would then direct you to look into those shows more. So it was almost like a census in a way of figuring out what impacted people the most, or what little stories impacted a handful of people that you've never heard of that you wanna dive deeper into. And that's really how we sculpted the 5 episodes.
Wilson, I want to ask you now, how does it feel moving into the role of executive producer?
it's been very interesting. I think my job as executive producer was getting access and asking my friends to take part, to trust me that this was something that they needed to be a part of, and that it was an important thing for us to talk about. I wanted to make sure that we were not just telling the story of the movement. We've seen that more times than I can count, documentaries and views on how the movement itself was created. But I wanted to see what it was that television did, what role television played and how we used it to our benefit. I think executive producers put on whatever hat needs to be put on in order to get the job done. Am I right?
Yeah. And Wilson will text anyone at any time.
At any time. I know. People now are like, I don't know if I'm going to give him my number.
Yeah. Amazing. Oh, thank you so much. It was so great to meet you all.
Thank
Good
you.
To see you.
Good to see you.
So,
Something about being on television makes people see you as part of our culture.
Women who looked like me could be the centers of their own universe.
When you see images that are reflective of your own life, it's a reminder to you that your life matters.
I didn't realize that I was the revolution that I was waiting for. I shouted out like a bird set free.